Hello and welcome to episode 2. Like I said, episode 1 ran a little long. I think I got too into it. Just a little bit. But I've smartened up. I now have a timer set so that I will never do it again. So I guess I'm literally on the clock now, so let's get a move on. Yeah, I can't quite remember. I think I was talking about the... is it the Well of Souls or the Soul Well? I can't remember what it's called now. Looks very World of Warcraft, and it reminds me of World of Warcraft, and everything in this game, sadly, kind of does. I said it before, and it's very clear that these guys were trying to make the quote, World of Warcraft killer, unquote. I feel like a lot of MMOs try to sort of, or given that title, or were trying to take that title. Whether or not they deserved it, remained to be seen.
You've made it, and look at you. Even with all you've been through, the Tuatha, your return from the dead. Please forgive me. You must be terribly confused by all of this. I am Fomarus Hughes, and this is my laboratory.
Oh, sorry. Yawning.
Everything you see here is dedicated to one thing.
Again, I just got out of bed.
Pursuit of immortality.
Let's start recording. This time I'm clothed. I should point out, I'm not in my underwear. Mainly because it's cold. If it was up to me, I'd always be in my underwear. Yeah, so what are fae?
Fae are complicated. I could write 10 volumes on the effects of immortality on the pseudo-feudal court system alone.
That tells me nothing, other than the fact that they're immortal. So you're the famous Hughes. Well of Souls, my death. Like, obviously, this is a really fun thing.
I wish I could tell you more, but...
Like, one of the big driving story plots is who was I before and why and where did I die? And the great thing is the game actually delivers on this. Sadly, it's one of the few things you don't get to choose. There is a preset who you are and why. But it's a good who you are and why, if I remember correctly.
Too much to explain right now.
I mean, it's kind of... I may be forgetting stuff, but it's kind of generic. But it's generic in a good way.
You're the only proof of what we've achieved here. I may not...
I don't know if... Honestly, I hope the dialogue isn't too quiet, because it's really quiet for me. I might have to mess with some audio stuff. Hey man, let's get out of here.
Yes, you're right. I've got my notes, but it's most important that you stay safe.
You can come with.
You're fascinating. Simply astounding. I'm not certain what's caused.
Where did these graphics come from? I hate how...
Yes, as I was saying, I'm not sure what...
I mean, look at it. It's actually... It's way better than in-game graphics.
Sir,
and I know it's obviously pre-rendered in some aspect. But it's just... Look at it. It's so much better. And it just looks less World of Warcrafty. This guy's going to do something that is so badass.
Find Agath. He's a friend, and he may be able to help. No matter what else, stay alive.
Agath is cool as well, but this guy does something. I love this. I love the wee. The little run that he's got is great. I always remember him pulling out two daggers and just going super gung-ho, but sadly he doesn't. In my dreams though. Is there anything good to pinch? Hughes, have you... No, he's all blocked. The game knows me too well. But yeah, I want to check real quick about... No, it's all maxed. Maybe I'll... No, you know, I'll leave it. If it's too quiet, I'll maybe do something in post, but we'll find it. Oh yeah, we've got sprint. Like, this is something, as you saw in there, you can set it in options to be hold and you run, or you tap it and you run. Like, the game is really good for sort of this customization stuff. Like, I was actually going to mention episode 1, but I got distracted, like everything else. The game has something that I wish so many more RPGs sort of had and had the option to do, which is basically choose whether or not you see the helmet that you're wearing. So you can still wear helmets, it's just the helmet is taken off or is invisible to the player. It sounds dumb, but I mean, it's one of these things, it's one of these sort of peeves of mine that if you put all this effort, excuse me again, burpees, to customize a character and put work into a face and then have to hide it behind a helmet, oh, that pisses me off so much. Yeah, so they have a troll. I rocked, oh, I was trying to roll and I pressed my crouch button. Whoopsie! Ow, let me... Ugh, oh, fucking troll. Might get rid of these Tuatha before I fight the troll, so... For some reason it's not letting me do my heavy attacks, and I don't know why. I think it might be something you buy later. Basically, you get the ability to, I think it's something you buy to do heavy attacks by holding the attack buttons. And you get sort of unique things for each kind of weapon and each stuff like staffs. You basically just charge up the spells and you do like a big powerful hit with daggers. If I remember rightly, you can do like some sort of rush attack, which is pretty cool. I will say the game does have, there's no sort of animation cancels or anything like that, so if you're in a combo and you really desperately want to dodge, you kind of just have to time your button presses a little better. Like I'm sort of doing right now. Little 1-2 roll, 1-2 roll, hey fuck you. Talking about, I feel like I had something important. I don't know, I've been really I was so spacey yesterday, it was unbelievable. I got up and obviously I was recording, and then it's because I had some sort of meeting that I was supposed to do yesterday, and well, not supposed to do it, was I generally had meetings on Wednesdays every week, but I just so happened to not have one this week. And I won't be having one for an Onassis one. Oh! That's basically something special you get to do with certain... You build up a meter and you get special kills. And there's unique kills. There's loads of different ones. There's different weapons you use, like the spears, one you use a few times. You get giant daggers, a giant hammer. I think you get one that's specifically magic looking. Oh, you get 2 ring slots. Even though you have 10 fingers, most games only give you 2 ring slots. 2 to 4. You have 10 fingers. I want to be the Mandarin. Anyway, what was I talking about? Yeah, my spaciness. I think it was like my brain was so used to doing those meetings every Wednesday that yesterday was just so... Like, it felt like there was a big chunk of my day gone. Even though I filled it with something else, it was just like my brain just sort of went, I don't know how to handle this. And just for the entire day, I just didn't know what I was doing. I kept feeling like I had something huge missing from my day. So it just kept getting worse and worse, and then I kept thinking I've forgotten other things because of it, and then it turns out I didn't, and then, or did in some way, I don't know, it was just, ugh. So yeah, here's the list of skills you get. Not a lot, you know, you get dispelling. I might go for that actually. Detect hidden. So you obviously do get occasional hidden enemies. Oh no, that's just shows enemies on the map. Hidden treasures, that's that one. That one does hidden treasures. I've already got stealth level 1. What's your chance? Purple gems. I don't know. See, again, this is the problem. This is the one sort of problem. Your character class doesn't determine these skills. So yes, you could be a rogue, sort of, you could be a stealthy mage kind of character, but you could also have skills, but you could have your base skills be blacksmithing. And, I don't know, merchantile? I never know how to pronounce that. So, picking. And I'll just go persuasion. That's usually what I go with. So here's the three trees that you get to work with. How many points have I got? 3. So like I said, yes, you do. You are sort of defined as stealth, strength, and magic. But then, like, you get to branch off from those. Let's try and get some spells. So, nope, that did not give me a spell. How did I get a spell? Where did I get those spells? Is this the charge attack? Yeah, let's do that. And let's do. To get them more. Let's do. Is this the one that does it? Shadow Strike. Yes, okay, so this is the one that does it. So let's. Oh. Yes, so let. I think this is the one. Yeah, so let's do that. Let's get the charge attacks from my daggers and my staff and then get the stealth skill. Shadow Flare. So I now can throw mist and then daggers. Pocket sand! Sorry. I remember hearing that be shouted out by somebody. And I totally forgot what it was from. Finally. So I literally just googled pocket sand. And the first thing that came up was, of course, the scene from King of the Hill where. Did he escape with you? Daryl? God, I'm forgetting his name and he's my favourite character. Just takes a pile of sand out of his pocket and throws it in a guy's face. It is completely out of context and it is hilarious. Like, I don't know why he's throwing sand in the guy's face. I don't care.
I'm sure he found a way to get out. He must have!
Yeah, so this guy is just very believing that Hughes survived the encounter.
Is remote enough that we don't get a lot of visitors.
Which, I mean,
and
come on.
Research,
I doubt it.
Fewer visitors means fewer questions.
Oh, so yeah, you can ask what a Fate Weaver is. Who you mean I got?
Once in a while. I never could figure out why they got along. He's friendly enough, if a bit.
If a bit odd.
You should be able to find him in Gorhart, just down the road, past the ruins. You can't miss it.
Like, I don't know if it's because my TV's really quiet, but I'm missing a lot of the dialogue.
At least a little.
Right, anyway, I'm going fishing, if it lets me. Come on, can I not dive off the. Oh, there it is. Yeah. Specific diving points, because. Screw you. Do-do-do, crude cotton robes. Those are gonna be soggy. Is there a path over here? Or is it, alright, it's the waterfall. Yeah, that's just, now that obviously I'm out in the real world, you'll be surprised on how big it is and how sort of cohesive it is. Like, everything is really well connected. Not Dark Souls really well connected, but as standard as it can get. Did I just hear somebody? Oh no, yeah, there's wild elk and stuff running around. So yeah, I mean, you can just sort of see the bare basics of it right now. The minimap is pretty big. I think, do I have... Yeah, so this is the map right now. Like, it looks small on the minimap, but then you get to get in and it's reasonably large. Is there a lot of stuff in it? Yeah. You know, you get these sort of things, you get passive sort of additional buffs with timers by praying to gods. You get something called lore stones, which are basically just collect-a-thon sort of stuff, each sort of telling different stories. Am I being attacked by a bear? Wait, does it know I'm here? Apparently it does, or something does. I'm just gonna... stealth attack on a bear! Ah! Oh yeah, I can show my charge attack. Ha! Ha!
Ah. I remember you.
Sorry, I didn't mean to skip that.
You're the one? How did you come back? How did you find me here?
Did you know about the attack?
No, I had no idea anything like that would happen. The Well of Souls is bigger than one gnome's pet project. My employer pays for information about its progress. I just send the reports to make some money on the side.
Yeah, so if you can, you may not get it yet. But gnomes in this world are decks. Pay me enough.
I don't have... Okay. Here.
They're all...
It's all I've got. Plus what I got paid
sort of as every generic sort of thing makes them very academic based. They're all... If you're not smart, or if you don't have a job, or if you don't have a particular skill base, you're useless. Yeah, this is the charge dagger attack. I think you can... Can you not combo it, or am I crazy? Maybe we'll do it later, but for now you can. Anyway, is there a lore stone? I feel like... I should point out, I'm not going to try and collect everything. I'm not going to try and... I'll definitely do a lot of side quests and stuff. What would I do? That, yes, you can, like, as you see, combo if you hit something. Which I think is awesome looking. Ah! Oh, that looked a bit glitchy. Yeah, I will say the weird thing, even though you have mana, you kinda can't spam your magic. As you see, it does have a cooldown timer, which... I honestly don't know how I feel about it. You obviously can make it be a small... Hey, fuck you! Be a smaller timer. You can, you know, you can reduce it as much as you want. But... It's still weird. Yeah, I had a thing I was gonna say. Yeah, I'm not gonna try and waste a lot of time hunting for lore stones and stuff, mainly because even in my completed playthrough, I never found all of them. I found a good fair bunch, but not all of them. Why am I coming in here? I don't know. I just sort of saw a cave and went in. What else am I gonna do? I'm an explorer. Yeah, and as you saw, there's no sort of silly... Oh, every cave just happens to have a door, because you need doors. I mean, when Fallout 4 came out, that blew my mind that they had no doors to their caves. They still had... You still had, if I remember, at least they had to collect A to go in them. But there was no doors, so they looked more natural. Oh, I just got... what the fuck? Yeah, so you do have a lockpick minigame that's, again, very reminiscent of other sort of games. They obviously tried to change it by making iron shock disc. What the hell is this? Ooh. Wait, is that a chakram or is that a... or is it a ring? I'll take all of it anyway. What was I thinking? Yeah, the lockpicking look, they obviously tried to make it look different, but it just works the same as any other sort of lockpicking mechanic. That was weird. What was that iron shock disc thing? Was it a... no? Was it a chakram? Must have been a component or something. Weird. And I think, like I said, I said it in the first episode, I think that was the biggest problem with this game was it just sort of had this... like, it was kind of the game's downfall, was it just had this feel of trying to oh, I keep getting hit by traps. And I'm not even noticing them at all. I kind of forget there's a guy in here. I think there's supposed to be story stuff in here that I'm sort of advancing slightly unintentionally. But yeah, it just had this unlucky sort of association of just looking like everything else out there. And it's a real shame because I honestly do find this game really enjoyable. It just got sort of stuck looking like other stuff. Yeah, as you can see, I think the downside to the charge attacks is the fact that they don't necessarily work the way you'd expect. You have to still do a hit and then you get the charge, which is a little weird to me. Like, I'm holding it, not pressing it and holding it. Well, most of the time, anyway. Fucking sand! I'm not gonna say that every time I use that skill. Or am I? But yeah, I mean, look, I mean, even, like, these are supposed to be kobolds. That's a very classic sort of D&D creature, and this design is so unique. It's so different looking. Like, when I hear the word kobold, I imagine these small, like, I don't know the best description. Sort of, like, guess goblin-like, but these guys are tall tiger creature things with bat ears and stuff. The bat ears are definitely a kobold thing. I would say they're small bat ears. Yeah, I don't know why I came in here. I know I've got a quest that I suppose I'm probably trying to stealth this, but seeing as I am a stealthy wizard. I mean, I haven't actually even been given my class yet. I mean, that's the thing, you're probably thinking, oh... you may assume that because I picked those skills, I have a class. I actually don't have a class yet. That is supposed to have happened. It's supposed to have happened, but I haven't spoken to the guy that does it for you yet. Because basically, when you pick a class, you actually get passive bonuses for picking said class. Did I keep... ah, shit. This place is infested. I didn't say it, but I'm going to say it now. Pocket sand! But yeah, you get... like, if you pick a stealth class, And obviously to pick certain classes you need to have certain amount of, a certain number of points in a particular tree. So I think, I'm trying to think what, when I have the most points on that. It's probably going to be Rogue class I'm going to have to pick for now, because I have more points in the Rogue tree, in the finesse tree, than I do the Sorcerer tree. Which is fine, obviously that, it's something that can change over anytime you want, because like I say, it's like the job system of the Final Fantasy games. You can change them whenever you have the opportunity to. Oh, Jesus. I really should use my shield more, but I just don't like using it. I'm not picking up everything, like all the mushrooms and stuff, because I don't know if I'm gonna. I think that's alchemy stuff. Excuse me. Again. I don't know if I'm gonna be using that. Did I miss anything over here? No. Okay, so let's keep going. And I mean, again, I keep bringing up the whole World of Warcraft comparison, but as you can see with this cave, they try their best to sort of give everything this really unique look. Like, there's all this, there's all these fungi everywhere with different colours. They're really bright and vibrant. That's the thing about this game I like. It has a sense of character with its sort of cartoony style, as well as a sense of intense colour. Like, my big thing with Skyrim and stuff, I do love those games, but even Skyrim can get drab. It has its the thing about Skyrim, it's very drab on the outside, and I mean on like the surface layer, but then when you do occasionally find these moments of bright colour, and I think it gives it a sort of unique moment, like, oh my god, look what I found all this. Wait, stop doing that. I found this nice little patch of all these beautiful plants and wildlife and stuff. Whereas here it's sort of everywhere, and I think it's sort of, I'm gonna die. It definitely doesn't detract from its uniqueness. Like, it's still very pleasant to look at least in my opinion. Anyway, I'm just trying to keep a close eye on the time, because I think I'm coming up to the end. Oh, so there's a new wee wand. We'll probably use Receptor's good, I can't remember. So now I've got a little boop 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 boop. That's what it is. Scepters are like your magic bow and arrow, basically. Sorry, I keep checking the time. I don't want to have the alarm that I've set go off, because it is very loud. There's a hammer. Ooh, an average lock. Might actually need to be moved. Oh, shit. I don't know if that's getting picked up, but yes, it does vibrate, and you do sort of get good indicators of when it's going to snap. It's just like, again, like any other RPG. Am I going to use a scepter? I've never used one before. I'm going to try my best to sort of do things I've not done before. That's why I've gone with a more magic-based class. Because usually I go stealth and strength. I mean, sure, I'm still going stealth, but I'm going magic instead. So, you know, that's different. So that's us just about coming to time. So if you're watching this, again, thank you very much. Please check out my other channel if you haven't. If you're coming from my other channel and you're checking this one out, again, thank you. Amalur may have something coming out on that channel, possibly, so it's a good thing that I'm playing this now. You know, get the footage. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I guess we'll catch you at the next one. See ya, we'll probably go meet the Fate Weaver guy.